Chris Powers is next.
Hi, my name is Chris Bowers with the Southern Environmental Law Center. Plant Mitchell's three coal ash ponds contain about 2 million tons of ash waste, according to 2010 records. The draft wastewater discharge permit covers ordinary wastewater discharges from these ponds. Under ordinary circumstances, discharges occur from the upper level of the water column. Is the form of treatment is to settle the relatively heavy waste toward the bottom, and that's how the water is treated under ordinary operations. Closing the ponds and dewatering or pumping out all the water from these ponds is anything but an ordinary operation. Dewatering will entail not only pumping out the entire concept of the ponds, but the water that is sitting or saturating in the ash. That is where all of the pollutants reside in higher concentrations. The concern we have with the draft permit is that Georgia Power hasn't submitted details concerning the wastewater treatment methods proposed to treat this highly impacted wastewater. This is a problem because the draft permit enables EPD to decide for itself that it isn't necessary to reopen the permit require, for instance, better treatment technology, more advanced methods in advance, so the public can weigh in, as we are doing today, on the specifics of the treatment methods to be applied to that dewatering waste stream, which again is a completely different nature of a waste stream than ordinary plant operations. To those that may feel the concerns that I've just described are merely a procedural or paperwork issue, I'll say two things today. First, coal ash wastewater is a major source of industrial water pollution. In fact, according to an EPA study of a couple years ago, they looked at all the waste streams from all the different types of industrial categories. It's in the top 10. It's not only in the top 10, it's number one. Not only is it number one, it's number one by a long shot. It's 2.5 times more toxic wastewater releases from this one industrial category than number two. 2.5 times. It's higher than the petroleum refining industry. It's higher than the chemicals, plastics industry, the fertilizer industry, and the pulp and paper manufacturing industry. Once released to the environment, these toxic pollutants, such as arsenic, lead, mercury, and selenium, persist in the environment for years. And that's again according to the EPA. These considerations underscore the importance of making sure that dewatering wastewater is adequately treated before they're released. And the treatment technology that's applied needs to be understood and weighed in by the community. Does the draft permit, as it's written, reflect technology-based treatment standards specifically for dewatering? The answer is no. And that's the problem, and that's the concern we have with this permit. My second response to the sentiment that these concerns are merely procedural or paperwork related is this. Instead of just being able to comment on a permit that merely requires a plan in the future, the public deserves to see that dewatering plan and details now, before the wastes are released, before the treatment is applied. Clean Water Act specifically calls for agencies, such as the EPD, to encourage public participation in important agency decisions. Once details are disclosed to EPD concerning how Georgia Power intends to treat the dewatering and wastewaters, EPD's evaluation of that plan is precisely the kind of important agency decision that this community, the public, deserves to know about in advance. The citizens of this community deserve an opportunity, like the one today, to know what the treatment technologies entail for the dewatering waste streams. For these reasons, we feel that the draft permit for Plant Mitchell should be withdrawn, substantially revised, and reissued for public comment, so as to prohibit dewatering discharge from these coal plants until EPD evaluates the coal ash dewatering plan now. We thank the EPD for this opportunity.
Thank you.
And we'll be submitting a detailed report.